It wasn't a fable written by Aesop, but there's a story about a stuffed hedgehog, preschool students at Greer's Gilmore Prep Academy, and the Greer Fire Department that was popular in 2018. The students at Gilmore Prep visited the Greer Fire Department Station 1 and presented the department with 104 stuffed hedgehogs for a very good cause.
Gilmore Prep Academy gave us hedgehogs to hand out to victims of fires, children that had suffered a fire or a traumatic incident. We got them to put on the trucks, and the Lions Club is still giving us the lions with the orange shirts on that have the Greer Fire Department logo on them. Well, they love them. The hedgehogs were the biggest hit because it's so squishy and soft. They love it.
The donation was the brainchild of Gilmore Prep Academy owner and director Tierney Rice and made possible by devoted parents.
So my preschool parents were very supportive, and they went out and they asked family and friends to buy a hedgehog. And for each hedgehog that was bought, we donated them to the fire department. And the reason we chose the fire department is because they are one of our first responders, of course. And we chose the Greer Fire Department because they're in our community. And they come in and they visit us during the school year to teach the children about fire safety. And they're always very kind and open to coming to talk with the children. So we ended up selling 104 hedgehogs, and we donated them all to the fire department.
That's amazing.
Rice said the project was also beneficial for her preschool students, who received a valuable social lesson by donating the hedgehogs.
And so at Gilmore Prep, we try to help the children become aware of others, being kind to others and being thoughtful of others. So in our interactions with them, we work very hard to teach them how to treat others and how important it is to care for others and to help others in any way that we possibly can.
Members of the fire department seek to pay back the community by hosting school groups at Station 1 throughout the year. In addition to fire safety tips, the students learn more about firefighting equipment and some of the activities that go into a typical day. Tours are coordinated through the fire department's administrative office. If you're feeling left out, don't worry. Adults have an opportunity to immerse themselves in the lives of firefighters through the City of Greer Fire Department's Citizens Academy held each fall.
I think the ultimate goal is to educate people or educate the community on what the fire department does. Because most of the time, people think that the fire department sits up there and watches TV waiting on a call to come in. They don't understand about pre-plans or training or certifications they have to obtain and those things. So it's one of those things that it's an educational tool for us.
The Citizens Academy graduated its third class in 2018. Its origins date back to Administrative Assistant Julie Hunter's second year with the city.
The year I came in, I took our Police Citizens Academy, and I wanted to do something so that the citizens know what their firefighters do on a daily basis. And I said, Chief, can we do a Citizens Fire Academy? He says, yep, it's yours, roll with it. And I've enjoyed every moment of it. The people, they become your family.
During the course, Academy participants learn about a firefighter's regular duties. On the final weekend, they're given an opportunity to experience such challenges as fire suppression, extraction, and repelling.
I'm extremely proud of everybody that participated, especially on Saturday, because I think a lot of you guys kind of stepped out of your comfort zone and faced a few of your fears. So, way to go.
We're not going to push anyone. We want them to be comfortable with what they're doing. I know that I took through it the first year, and they had to push me past my comfort zone. And it is surprising the ones that will step up and do it and go all the way up for the rappelling or go in the fire. You can see the fear, but they do conquer it and go on.
Conquering that fear helps participants feel that they have truly earned their certificate of completion. Like Rita Burns, who has participated in all three Citizens Academies, they also come away with a new respect for those who serve the City of Greer.
Well, this is my third time of taking the academy, but the first time we took it, it was like I was not aware exactly what the firemen really do. A lot of people have the conception that firemen stay here and just watch TV all day. That's wrong. They're continually training, learning things, and that's what we learned about the firemen. They're all the time training, taking CPR, taking all kind of classes to help make the fire department a better place.
Deputy Chief Holzheimer said community outreach programs help put human faces to the department's work.
We participated this year with the police department in Fist Bump Friday, which was a huge success because not only did we get to work with our brothers and sisters in blue, but we got to participate at the schools, which helped us relate to that they could relate to the firefighters. And they went through the classroom, and we participated in Real Men Read at Chandler Creek and Crestview. Being involved in the schools is a good thing because they get to see the firefighters, they get to relate to them, they get to understand them a little bit, and plus they love those shiny red trucks.
The department extended its outreach regionally in July when it hosted a stop for the Carolina Brotherhood Bicyclists.
We fight the unknown on a journey back home. What's waiting, I don't know. I'm trying not to let go, but I will climb until I reach that side. I'll look back knowing I tried, and I gave it up, I gave it up, I gave it up. But I will climb until I reach that side. I'll look back knowing I tried, and I gave it up, I gave it up, I gave it up.
So we've ridden 130 miles, 131 miles yesterday. That's no joke. Professional athletes don't even get to put that many miles on a bike. We're at 110 right now. We got another 12 to go. Today's been a hard day, and it's all for you guys. It's been a hot, long, lots of hills, making it happen, and it's all for you guys. So we want to say thank you for the opportunity, the honor to ride for your husband, for your dad, for your partner. You know, we'll all be able to, you're going to lead us out in the squad car, and we'll meet up at the arena as well. So we want to say thank you very much. Everybody's going to want to probably give you hugs. They want to meet you all day long, all nasty and sweaty, but that's, you know.
But I will climb until I reach that side. I'll look back knowing I tried, and that I gave it up, I gave it up, I gave it up. But I will climb until I reach that side. I'll look back knowing I tried, and that I gave it up, I gave it up, I gave it up.
Yeah, every year it's been very rewarding. I tell you what, it's not about us at all. It's about the lives of the men and women who lost their life in the line of duty and their families. It's about bringing back their memories, bringing back their life, recognizing them, and raising funds for their cause, for their family. It's not about us. I got involved 5 years ago. We had a line of duty death in Henderson County. I had the pleasure of escorting the Brotherhood through the county on honor of all line of duty death. And from that day forward, I've been a part of the Brotherhood.
But I will climb until I reach that side. I'll look back knowing I tried, and that I gave it up, I gave it up, I gave it up. But I will climb until I reach that side. I'll look back knowing I tried, and that I gave it up, I gave it up, I gave it up.
Technology and communications dominated the fire department's year in 2018. The department joined the Greer Police Department in switching to 800 megahertz radios, improving reception throughout the city limits. It also helped create the shared dispatch service that now includes Taylor's, Boiling Springs, and Pelham-Batesville.
It has been great. We're putting around 20 people on a residential fire and 25 plus on a commercial fire, which for the safety of our staff and all the staff around us, is incredible. And it's been great. You can see Bowling Springs, Taylor's, Pelham have all sent their staff to tour the dispatch center. And it's been well received. It's been a positive impact. And people are starting to look all over around the county at the city of Greer and Bowling Springs, Pelham, and Taylor. So it's a good thing.
The department also joined the police department in releasing the new computer-aided dispatch, or CAD system, as part of Greenville County's $5.5 million upgrade.
Instead of having to pick up phone calls and transfer them, it's done through what they call spawning. And EMS can drop a call to our dispatch center, or our dispatch center can drop a call to EMS, improving the efficiency of notifying other agencies in a timely manner. That was used to be done by dialing a 6-7-digit number to transfer it or get information back and forth. We also put MDTs in our apparatus, which allows us to view the same screen that the telecommunicators are viewing, and shares that real-time information where we can push button on scene, we can clear the call from that MDT, and we can see what resources are coming to us as well in that MDT. That was a big project. It also included automatic vehicle locators, which means that they can see where our trucks are, and it will dispatch based off of the closest unit response.
Along with the new technology that's put in the trucks with the MDTs, we've been working with our GIS department to also get the fire hydrants pre-plans on the computerized, and where they can actually pull them up on the MDTs instead of having to dig through notebooks. And the value of that with hydrants is they can actually see, determine what kind of water they're going to need on a fire, and they can look and see what flow is on the hydrant. That's why if you see them, the hydrants through the city are different colors. They're color-coded depending on the water flow that will come out of that hydrant.
The department responded to 3,509 calls in 2018, with rescue and emergency service calls comprising 60% of those alarms. The department fielded an equal number of service and good intent calls, 326 false alarms, and 124 actual fire calls. When not on calls, department members can often be found in training or professional development. In fact, they logged more than 13,000 training hours during the year, and two members surpassed the 1,000-hour mark, attaining a very special achievement.
In 18, the fire department became 100% EMT across the board. Engineer Macaulay Hanna and firefighter Austin Blanchard completed their National Registry paramedics, and we do now have two additional paramedics on staff, and we have three more are currently in paramedic school, which is it's a huge accomplishment. It was about a little over 1,000 hours of time away from home and away from their family, where they worked hard to pass that test and pass the skills that they needed to. Chief Keeley accomplished a huge accomplishment this year. He achieved his ICC Fire Marshal certification, and then he also completed his ICC Certified Building Official certification. Lieutenant Colby Means completed his Leadership Institute through the South Carolina State Firefighters Association. And Chief Flowers was elected to the Greenville County Fire Chiefs Board, Executive Board. And myself, I was elected to the South Carolina State Firefighters Board as their fourth vice president.
The Fire Marshal's office is keeping pace with rapid commercial and residential growth in the city of Greer.
Yeah, I have. I started out as a one-man band in 2000 when I moved over to the Fire Marshal Division. And since then, I have grown, added two more to my staff, and we stay very busy as far as with all the new construction and existing buildings. And a lot of people don't understand that once the building's finished being built, we're not through with it. We continue to go into it at least annually. Some of them we try to go in semi-annual for inspections. And then also when suppression, they have house fires or commercial fire, any type of structure fires, our responsibility is to investigate the fire and to see exactly what caused the fire.
From plan reviews, including 261 during 2018, to issuing certificates of occupancy, the Fire Marshal's office works closely with the Building and Development Standards Department to ensure safe construction in the city.
We look at it from the planning stages all the way up to the certificate of occupancies issued. But we work very well with them hand in hand. We try to accommodate the customer by we go out and inspect together at the same time, where we're not duplicating our services to those people. Sometimes we look at some of the similar things, but that way somebody doesn't have to spend twice as long on the job site doing an inspection with us and then turning around an hour later and working with the building department. So we try to put the customer service first.
Part of that customer service is ensuring that smoke detectors are present and working in homes. The department installed 129 smoke detectors in 2018 and took steps to make certain that landlords are held accountable for their tenants' safety.
We started something new in November of 18 that I think we're probably one of the first ones in the state doing this, along with the building department with our code enforcement on rental property, is we've gotten it passed where if we go into a rental property and they do not have smoke detectors, we can install the detectors and then we will bill the landlord for the smoke detectors. And if the invoice is not paid, then it is filed on their taxes.
Statistics show that nationally, 4 out of 5 child car seats are not properly installed. The City of Greer Fire Department has long been an inspection station for safe kids upstate. The department conducted 81 child seat inspections in 2018, a decline due to more neighboring agencies now offering inspection stations. Station 1 received a renovation in 2018 when the bunk room was transformed from an open dormitory to individual bedrooms for firefighters. And as the department headed into 2019, it began work to determine the condition of its equipment and facilities to meet the needs of a growing community.
Right now we're getting ready to go through our facility study. Get ready to understand, look at the buildings, and understand, you know, one was built in 1974 and the other was built in 1990. Looking at those buildings and seeing where they fit in today. Are they meeting the needs of our organization, and what are the structural components of it, and so on from there. And we're excited to serve the city, I mean, and keep changing to meet the needs of our citizens.